So hello students, so today we will continue lesson 13 and today we will study about the functions. Okay, so first is the simple functions. So all these functions are pre-designed formulas. So in the last classes we have learned how to apply the formulas on the values we have stored in the Excel. So in the functions, formulas are already written in the Excel, so we are going just only to use it. Okay, so what does the function contains? Function has two parts, argument and structure. One is the structure and another is the argument. So in the formula, what we are writing after equals to and some values we are writing, so that is the argument. So that argument in the functions we write inside the parenthesis, small bracket open and small bracket close. So here first of all we take some value. Suppose here we are going to take this field, okay. We are going to write down sales, and this is sales we are going to write for the respective months. So here the value I will write, suppose the sales of rupees 1000, next month the sales of rupees support 2000, next month the sales of rupees 1200, next month the sales of rupees of 600, next month the sale of is of rupees 780. Suppose respective these sales are there 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 months. So here we have written the sales of 5 months for a particular shop. Now we will use the simple function here to add all these sales to find the total of the sales. So suppose it's a total we want to add. Fine. Here before we add one more column. So make a right click on the column header. Okay. So insert option you get. See one column is inserted before. So here he wants the total sale. So what we write? Total sales. Now here we increase the width of the cell. So to increase the width of the cell, here we click on the column header and the arrow will convert it into the crosshair shape. Now we drag it. So it's going to increase. Now here we will write the function. We will use the function. So to use the function also, we have to use the equals to operator. Assignment operator we have to use in this case also. So what we write? Equals to. And after that we write the sum function. The first simple function which we are going to study, that is the sum function. So there are some rules to enter the function name. So all functions must begin with equals to sign. That is the first rule, that all functions will begin with the equals to sign. And the second is function name must be a valid Excel name. So here see all our functions name is given in the list. So you have to use some valid function name. We have sum if, sum if s, sum product, sum sq, sum x2, my2, all these are the valid function names. If you are writing any function which name doesn't exist in the Excel, so that will not work. Third rule, function must be followed by opening and closing parenthesis. So every function has the opening parenthesis and its closing is also mandatory. So first you open and close the parenthesis and the cursor is between this parenthesis. Now we inside this parenthesis whatever we write, that is called the argument, that is called the, and this entire thing is the structure of the function. So structure says that what should be the skeleton of the function, how you write the function. So equals to operator is needed, and after that we use the valid function name and opening and closing parenthesis, and that is the entire structure. Now in this structure, inside the parenthesis we pass the argument. That is the argument you can pass as a value also. Argument you can pass the cell reference which contains the value. We can pass directly value also. See, here first of all we pass directly some value. So in this suppose he wants to add two. So we are writing here equals to sum parenthesis open, in there we write 2 plus 3 plus 9, close the parenthesis. See what we written, 3 in this value, in this argument parenthesis we pass 3 values, 2, 3, 9. So what the sum will get? 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 9, 14. This is the sum we are expecting. Now we press the enter key. So when we press the enter key, we get the sum. See what we got? 14. So in the parenthesis, what we passed? That is the argument. So this argument can be any number. All the separate numbers, all the numbers should be separated by comma symbol. We use comma to separate the different arguments. Next, on the same place, see here, in the same place, on the place of these values, now I am going to edit the formula, go in the formula, text box, where the formula is appearing, that I have deleted. Now in that place, we want to pass the address, cell reference. So the cell reference here, this time we are going to pass, suppose we want to just cell. So we click on this, already see, this is a reference B4. The cell which contains the value 1200 is B4. So we have click on the, you can directly write its address also. So if you do not knowing the address of the cell, so you click on that cell. Its address will automatically will be added in the parenthesis. Next, after that you must do. See, first you have added, after that we give the comma to separate the other, comma given, next value you must add 600. See, two values we have given. And third also, again you give the comma, and third argument we added, or B6. After that, what we will do? We press the enter key and see the result. 2580. So all these values, which is present in the given cell address, what we have used, that is added. This is the second method. Third, you can pass the argument as a range also, which we have done many times in the progress report also. So means the range of the values. Suppose you have now in this on the place of this again we are going to edit the formula. So let me delete all this. Now this time we will pass the range. Range means here the value we started from B2. The first address of the 1000 is what? This is present in the cell B2. See the address. What is the address of this? B2. B column, second row. And the last address of the 780 where value is present in that cell address is what? B6. So we will select this. Automatically, so then you will select it. See? So you select that value automatically. B2 column B6 is added in the parenthesis. Okay, now press the enter key. See, you want the sum, you got 5580. Okay, now so this sum functions are of different type. So first time we have taken in the sum function, we can add the numbers as argument. Second, we can add the reference, the cell reference which contains the value. Third, we can pass the range of the references, and here the fourth one we will study in this sum. Some other things also we can use. Now combination of these two addresses, you can use the range also, you can use any number also. So that combination also we can use in the sum function. Now see that. So here you find in this we have used the range. Now after this range, you want to sum another value also, suppose one more month sales you got at the present time. So suppose that month is current month sales you got 500. So what do we write? Comma. Because to separate the value, sum function, inside the parenthesis, every argument is separated by comma. So put the comma and write after there 500. So see, comma 500. Now press the enter key. So previously what the result you got, in that 500 more will be added. So previously what you got the result? Do you remember?
5580.
Yes. Now see this time 6080. So in this what we have done? Combination of different arguments we can also place inside the parenthesis. Now next another thing we will learn. Now see in this one more thing we will do. Some more addition. Here you can use the logical value also. The logical value for the true. The true value means 1. The logical value for the true is what? 1. Now this time, I will write the one logical value true after 500. So 1 will be added. The logical value of the true is what? Excel takes 1. And for the false, 0. Now here, put comma and write 2. See, written? Now this time again, you press the enter key, see the result.
6081.
So this, we have added true here, but what we are getting the result. So Excel is what doing? Excel is converting the true. This is a boolean value, it's a logical value. So the logical value is in the bit form. So the logical value for the true is 1 and for the false is 0. So its logical value is added. Now next time again, if suppose another change is given in it, now true added, again put the comma. Now this time, if you add a false, so that is the 0 only, no changes will be there. See false, you are getting the same result, no changes because its value is what? 0. Next, we do some more changes, false we use. Now after that, we use in double quotation mark, that is called the string. So in the string, if you write any number, so first it will convert that string into a number. Then it will add it. Suppose in the string I have written here 5. And after that you press the enter key. See, again 5 will be added in there. 6086. So Excel is doing what? Your string, it is converting into the number. Now this time you add some any alphabet. We are using here capital A. So because the absolute value of a number A, a number without its sign. So what you are getting here? Error. Means if you are writing here A in the alphabet, so it is expecting that you are going to write some any function. Any function. So no offense. So what the function we have used in A, that is not a proper function, not a valid Excel function. So that's why it display the error. Now, after that the average function is here. So this average function returns the average of the arguments. So whatever the argument you select, its average it will calculate. Now on the place of that we use the average here. So here in this, we want to calculate the average. So first let's delete this. We write average equals to average inside the parenthesis. Inside the parenthesis, we get plus equals to. Okay, average. So we want to calculate the average of the entire sales value. So what is the average sale of the year? Suppose is that. So here we have taken only 5 months for you know, not whole year. So one more we take, we add here 1748. This address is added apparently. Okay. So now we are going to select this entire value. Now its range is selected. Press the enter key. Updated. Okay. So this is selected. Press the enter key. You will get the average 1116. This is the average sale of the 5 months. So in average, what is doing? Total value, total sale upon number of sales. Total sale divided by number of sales. Total sale 5550. We are getting. That's divided by 5. So when you divide 5,580 by 5, you will get 1,116, the same value you get. You can check it also here by writing down, you can write the formula here also, equals to 5,580 divided by 5, that is now. Now see, 1,116. So we can use this Excel as a calculator also, anywhere you write the value equals to, and the value interest and entropy, you will get the result. Okay, this average, in this also you can pass the numbers to calculate the average. Suppose here you want to calculate the average, same what you get equals to average. Now in the parenthesis you write some value. Suppose I want to calculate the average of 15 comma 45 comma 8 comma 65 comma 63. So this is much numbers argument we have taken here, 15, 45, 8, 65, 63. That type of average function also we can use. So how many values are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this will be added, and after adding sum will be divided by 5. So press enter, 39.2. You get the average 39.2. Next also you can use as a true value also in the average here. Again make some changes, after this use comma you write true. So 1 will be added on the average, comma, true, average will change. Present up 32.833. Now the place of true 1 is added and number of observations become 6. Okay, now let's see the count function. So this, what is the count function? Count function counts the number of numeric entries formula. Numeric entries formula and date entries in a given range of cell. What it will count count function? Numeric entries, if any formula you written in the cell, that will also, and date entry if you have written, that also it will count. But empty cell it will not count. So see, if you want to count here, see how many values are there. So what we write equals to, again equals to count, C-O-U-N-T, count function. Now in the count function, what we write here, we select the column range from where you apply the count. We want to apply the count from this to this. See, taking this one, press the enter key. See how many cells we have taken. 5, 1, 6. 6 cells we have selected. No? Press the enter key. You will get the count 6. You will get the count 6. Now this time if you use the empty cell here in between, so that it will not count. Suppose the same formula, I am going to write it here, copy and paste. See this here. First we copy this count function. Make a right click on it. Copy. Now copy. Now here in this cell you paste it. So what this time happens? This time its count is 4. So what the address is there? B5 to B10. It is taken B5 to B10. So this much is taken. See how many spaces are there? 1, 2. 2 empty cells are there, but it has not counted. It has counted only those values which have some text. 600, 780, 11, 1066. So empty cell will not count. So many data you have, in there some cells are empty. If you want to count that how many entries are there, with that the count function you can count the total number of entries in which some value you have added. Now if you pass any value, so that also it will count. So suppose you here we added some range, and after that you give comma 2, in some value you have to count your adding comma 2. So what it will do this time? Can you expect what the result you will get this time? In this we have made the changes in the formula. What we written? B colon to B10 comma 2. What will get the result? So this 2 will also take its entry. It will count it as a 1 entry. And it will add the value in the count by 1. So previously you are getting 4. Now you get what? 5. Press the enter key. See what you are getting? 5. Means after that you write whatever the numbers you write in the count function as the argument, that will be treated as a as a data, and it will speak, it will print one argument as one value. So two arguments you added, so two more numbers will be added in the count values. So next is the max function. Max function. Suppose you want to use here max function. Now the place of the total cells, let me give this, and here we will use the max function. Max function. Max function is whatever the arguments you select, whatever the cells you select, in out of those cells, which cells contain the maximum value. So max function will return the maximum value out of the all selected values. So here we select all the values, and out of that it will return the maximum one. So here, till here we have selected, close the parenthesis. Now see what we got. The maximum entry is what? 2000, as you can see, it has returned. Okay, so if the many cells are given, and out of that, if you want to find which one has the highest cell, do the max function and select all the data, it will return you the highest number of cells. Okay, so suppose. Next, in this also, where we take the max value here. Now put the comma. The range I have given, now some additional value also we can give in it. It will take the range also, and some additional value what we are giving, that also it will compare. Out of that it will tell the maximum. See, another value I am writing here. This I am writing 2200. 2222 plus enter key. See what you are getting? 2222 is the maximum. Yes. Next function is the today function. If you want to write the date of today, so here we are writing today function equals to, and we write today. Today function. See what is the today date? 3rd February. 2021. So that is the first one. Here it is the month, this is the date, and this is the year. So today function will give you the display the current date in the selected cell. Now, if you want the month, if you want the month name, so what you write? Before that you write month. Go there in this formula, before that you write month. Month of today. So in this you write M-O-N-T-H, month, again use the one parenthesis, and after that this, another parenthesis, you close it. Okay, so now the month function you use, month function inside the month, to find the month you have to give the date first. If without telling you the date, how can you tell about the month date? So today function is to give, today function will return the date, out of that date the month function will find the month number. Now press the enter key. Right, next one equals to day in the parenthesis. You use today, parenthesis open and close. Yes, see now here. So today's, what is the date? 3. So that is written here 3. So we written here for day. What is the date today? Next year we write again. So if you want to see the 1 again that equals to 1 in parenthesis you write today parenthesis close. Now this is second, that is the second month, no? February. So that you are getting the result. Okay, next is the if condition. If function, you learn about the if function. So what does the if function will do? If the, this is a conditional function, it returns one value. If a condition you specify equals to true and another value if the condition equals to false. So if condition is used to compare the condition what you have given, if the result is true, so it will return one value. If the result is false, it will return the another value. So see how we use this if condition. So equals to, we write if in the parenthesis, in the parenthesis first argument you can give here. If suppose you are writing 15, inside the parenthesis you write 15 is greater than symbol we use for the comparison is greater than 15 greater than or 12, 15 greater than 12. So that is the condition you have to give. First argument should be a condition. So the condition what we have given, 15 greater than 12. If this condition is true, so the result statement will be the true statement will be the next second one. So whatever you write on the place of the second argument, that will appear. So if 15 is greater than 12, so I am writing here some value. In double quotation mark, I am writing amazing. Now, if 15 is greater than 12, it is true, so it will display my name. Otherwise, false, it will display some other's name. So, again, I will write the other name. That is the quotation mark. We have to write string it is Mahesh. Now close the parenthesis. Understand now, see. If 15 is greater than 12, if the condition is true, so it will display my name. Otherwise, it will display Mahesh on the same place. Press the enter key. So here, if 15 is greater than 12, to accept the correction we guess to close this message through correction. See what we got here? The name. That is true. Okay. So this is all for today, students. In the next class we will continue the remaining topics of this lesson. Shut down the system, leave the lab.